Brie, can you start us off with the elevator pitch of this movie?
What's an elevator pitch? Oh, like you run into someone in an elevator and you're like, I got this story for you? So like the sleazy version?
No,
of
just
this?
like concise, but really get it. Yeah.
Okay, so we're not stuck in an elevator.
Not stuck. Say.
Okay, we've
not
got a
stuck.
Couple for it.
Yeah.
I play Kit. She is an artist at heart, but has dealt with some no's and failures and is questioning her heart and her identity as an artist. So she decides to be a normal person and get an office job. But once she does, she starts receiving these like very magical invitations to a place called The Store. She arrives there and Samuel L. Jackson is there as a, as a unicorn salesman and explains to her that he can give her this thing that she's always wanted, her dream since she was a child of a pet unicorn or a unicorn friend. And they don't cost anything. She just has to prove that she deserves it.
And Brie, this is your directorial debut. Congratulations.
Thanks.
So what did you find to be much more difficult about directing than you expected?
To be honest, I kind of knew going into it that it was going to be hard. I didn't think that it was going to be a breeze to go through it. And I was lucky in that a lot of this is like the stamina of the creative process that's not dissimilar to acting at all. It's like you go through the normal cycles when you're working on something for like many years where some days you're like, this is amazing. And other days you're like, I'm a failure and this is a disaster. But I have enough trust in the process because I've done it enough that it was really great. I mean, more than anything, it felt inspiring to assemble a team that were constantly surprising you and making you excited every day. And this movie was about making each other laugh. And that was a really nice change.
To me, watching her on set looked like a breeze. It's like, how are you like just vacillating from like, oh, why? To like, okay, let's set up this shot here and blah, blah, blah. And I was like, how is this possible? Anyway.
I got a lot of people in my brain.
I see.
Switch into my different people.
I was like, what? Who is she?
Anytime I decide to do a job, there's something in me that sort of pulls me towards it, and I don't fully know why or what it is, and I like that. I like that I don't have the answer to it, because if I know what my motive is for making something, it's not fun anymore, because you're not searching for something. You're just like, oh, I'm doing it because of that. I'm boring to myself. So doing this film, it was always really, it triggered something in me that felt very real, and I didn't know what that was until I started going through home movies to add in the sequence of young Kit, and I found all this footage of me as a little kid talking about wanting a unicorn, and it was so, yes, it's so weird. It's so weird. It really like gave me chills when I saw it because I was maybe, I don't know, 4 or 5 years old. I don't have any memory of it, so I guess I've wanted a unicorn.
I was 15.
Even before.
I was like, I want a unicorn.
Still want one now.